Pipedream could target U.S. infrastructure, Ukrainian cybersecurity prevented a major energy sector attack, and RaidForums is seized by law enforcement. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for April 19th, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. There are several industrial attacks happening across borders this week, so on to the first news story. A joint advisory from the Department of Energy, the DOE, the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Agency, which is CISA, the NSA, and the FBI was released last week and explains that advanced persistent threat, APT, attackers have new tools that could allow them to get full access to industrial control systems, or ICS, along with SCADA devices like the ones used for the energy sector. The APTs have already demonstrated that they can gain full access via their custom-made tools. Specifically, this includes Schneider Electric PLCs, Omron Sysmac NEX PLCs, and Open Platform Communications Unified Architecture servers. If one of these servers got infected, that could lead to a full compromise, including an elevation of privileges, using the server for lateral movement throughout a network, critical device or function disruption, etc. That includes sabotaging critical functions for liquefied natural gas like oil refinery sectors and the electrical power grid sector. The agencies also mentioned that Windows-based engineering workstations could be compromised too by exploiting a known vulnerability within the ASRock motherboard driver. Now, this information comes to light from the ICS security firm Dragos, who nicknamed these malicious tools as Pipedream. Now, Pipedream is not the first tool used to target ICS. It follows in the footsteps of Stuxnet, of Crash Override, Triton, and several more over the years. Dragos believes that this attack can be attributed to the APT actor Chevronite. To note, earlier this year, Mandiant also analyzed the malware for Schneider Electric, and they called the tool InController. Dragos mentions that this has not been used in the wild yet in real-world attacks, though it's entirely possible. It's important because, according to the VP of Threat Intelligence at Dragos, quote, "This is the most expansive industrial control system attack tool that anyone has ever documented. They're calling it the Swiss Army knife of attacks due to the amount of tools built into this toolkit." Now, because this APT group has already demonstrated their ability to use Pipedream, the agencies recommend infrastructure orgs isolate ICS and SCADA systems, create and manage perimeter controls, limit communications entering or leaving the network, and use multi-factor authentication for access, as well as changing passwords and removing any default passwords. To build on this story, we also have more critical infrastructure attacks happening across the pond. Lots of industrial attacks happened this week, although one potential attack failed during its deployment. Ukraine's Computer Emergency Response Team thwarted this Russian APT group called Sandworm, who tried to attack an undisclosed energy provider in their region. According to a notification by CertUA, Sandworm attackers attempted to target the electrical substations using InDestroyer 2 malware, Windows operating systems using the Caddy Wiper, Data Wiper, Linux-operated server equipment using Destructor scripts, and active networking equipment. Now, Caddy Wiper, in particular, has also been seen infecting Ukrainian bank networks in recent weeks. Researchers suspect the wipers could be used to destroy evidence of the malware after its attack. If InDestroyer sounds familiar, that's because it was used back in 2016 against Ukraine's power grid. So this was an updated version. This malware is also called Crash Override, aka by some researchers, and it also has the ability to control circuit breakers and switches at electricity stations. The new version can also take over protection relays at substations, so it can be quite dangerous. That 2016 attack did cause power outages and blackouts. But attacks that could do this have not been seen since then. So it seems like the invasion of Ukraine is also reintroducing old tricks with updated versions. Sandworm attacked in two phases. One happened in February of 2022, then the second was set to occur on April 8th, 2022, when they planned to shut down the substations and the infrastructure. But this was prevented, though, when the energy provider detected the attack while it was happening, and they stopped it before the attackers could cause another blackout. Now, it's not clear how the attackers actually gained that initial access, nor how they moved from an IT network over to the ICS network. But this group is believed to work for Russia's GRU, the main intelligence directorate. In recent times, this group has also targeted ASUS's routers with the Cyclops Blink botnet, and we will likely see Sandworm continue their attacks, given they apparently never left after the successful energy sector attack of 2016. Big shout out to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. And a big thank you to Ben for joining the Alliance over at patreon.com/threatwire. This week, I'm trying something new. I have a fourth story to cover, which will only be available to the Patreon Alliance. So check that out if you are interested. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story about hacker forums. Now, one of the largest hacker forums in the world, which was used to sell stolen personal information, was seized by international law enforcement in a coordinated effort, which was called Tourniquet. The website is called RaidForums, and it was seized by law enforcement from the US, the UK, Sweden, Portugal, and Romania. An arrest of the alleged forum admin was also made in England. This admin, who went by the name Omnipotent, is said to be the founder as well. They're a 21-year-old Portuguese national who was arrested on January 31st and awaits extradition to the US. Raid Forums had more than 500,000 users since launching in January of 2015, and databases of stolen data included more than 10 billion unique records. They contained credit card and bank account information, financial info, social security numbers, usernames, and passwords connected to this info, and a lot more. It's likely that law enforcement had access to the Raid Forums data and servers since February 7th, which is when the site started having database outages until it eventually and mysteriously went offline, with the seizure happening around February 25th. Now, given that the Hydra marketplace was taken down last week by law enforcement, it appears there's a lot of these investigations that are now reaching a major turning point. I still don't think it's the end of them, though, because we always see new marketplaces and new forums pop up in their place, but I'm curious to see what's going to happen next. Do you want to see more tech videos from me? Check out my YouTube channel, youtube.com/ShannonMorse, spelled just like my name, for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. Like, I just did a recent video about malware and tax season scams. And with that, do not forget to like and subscribe to Hack5 as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.